about today. Amen. And I pray that your faith will be strengthened. Amen. Because of this morning pray and because of this morning dedication to God, your eyes and your heart, amen, will be open to the things of God. And we're grateful for those who are joining us this morning because this is international pray that we thank God for Timothy London, amen, who is watching. God bless you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Psalms 119 verse 102 also said, I have not departed from thy judgment, for thou hast taught me, amen, how sweet are thy words unto thy taste, yea, sweeter than the honey, amen, in my mouth, amen. So we're keeping the precepts of God this morning. We're keeping the word of God that we be able to depart from the judgment that is in the earth. Amen. And now we're walking in truth and we're walking in righteousness. God bless you, Sister Claudette, for joining with us in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Then David encouraged us. He said, thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto thy path. And that's why we are here this morning, that we will not stumble. Amen. The principle of God's word, if we keep that lamp, that word as a lamp, amen, we will not fall into danger. Amen. We will not walk into anything that is false. Amen. Because fear is a false thing to keep us away from God. Amen. And this morning we wake up with all the strength of God in us. Thank you, Maureen Singh from Trinidad. God bless you for joining with us. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So we're grateful this morning for all of you. Thank you, Sister Patty Ann. Praise God. We will be praying for Sister Patty Ann's family today. I think that funeral is today in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We lost a great warrior in Trinidad. Amen. Minister Sean Henry, glory to God, who has gone home to be with the Lord. Amen. And I want to pray. Bishop Brandt has gone to represent me there, amen, and represent World Assemblies of Restoration there. And the funeral was yesterday. They had a wonderful funeral, but we are going to pray for the family because they're still going through a little hardship because, you know, they just spoke to him a few hours ago, and then quick like that, he went home to be with the Lord. So we're going to be praying for that family this morning in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And before we begin to pray, we're going to pray for pastors and ministers. Amen. We're going to pray for our government in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We're going to pray for our school. Amen. And then we're going to pray against prejudice because there is a spirit of prejudice that is trying to arise back in this country. We're going to come out against it in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Glory to God, and we're going to see the hands of God working on us and working through us. We see God answer our prayer on this prayer line. Just one day, we told the Lord something, and by the end of the day, thank you, Pastor Sandra Fredericks out of Trinidad. Thank you for joining with us in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Courtney Walcott, God bless you also for joining with us in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And everywhere that you are, God bless you. God bless you. God bless you, Pastor Mac. God bless you out of Ghana. Thank God. And then we thank God for you, Bishop Frank. God bless you. Thank you for joining with us. Amen. Bishop Gary George, God bless you. Thank you all for joining with us. They're coming from everywhere. And they're lining up this morning to join us in prayer. We're going to open up this morning in prayer. Amen. And we believe God to answer our prayer in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Pastor Hinds, you heard all of those requests. I know that you have not written down all of them, but we thank you. Amen. But we want you to open up and what you don't remember, pray in tongues. Amen. And the Lord, amen. God bless you. We would open us up and pray in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. God bless you in Jesus' name. God bless you, Evangelist Al. Thank you. The blessings of the Lord be upon you also in the name of the Lord Jesus. We're praying for all of our, even our people who are saints who are working and in the workplace in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, that God would keep his hands upon them also in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Bless you as you pray for us today in Jesus' name.
Father, you are to be praised. As we come today in the name of Jesus, you are to be glorified. Your name is to be celebrated.
Yes.
We thank you, Lord, for your goodness and your mercy.
Yes, yes.
We are glad because this morning we can offer praise to glorify and bless your
name.
We thank you for your might and your power.
Glory
to
Kabahashara Bamba Hosidi.
We thank you for a brand new day of compassion.
Yes, yes.
We are so glad because your mercies does not fail.
Yes.
We're glad, glory be to God, hallelujah, because in every generation, you look down with mercy and compassion.
Yes.
We are grateful, glory be to God, as we offer the praise, as we lift up your name, as we glorify your name.
Yes.
We thank you, Lord, for another day, glory be to Jesus,
yes,
that we can command our morning.
Yes.
Glory be to God, hallelujah,
yes.
With praise and worship.
Glory. Kashadabandi okota
yasanda. Bless you as we grow you, as we magnify you, as we lift thee up.
Yes, yes.
As our hearts are filled with joy,
yes.
Because your hands have been outstretched towards us. Glory be to God. We come to make a petition. Glory be to God to thee this morning.
Yes.
As we bless your wonderful name.
Yes.
Because you have encouraged us to ask, and you said in your word that whatsoever we ask
the Father in Jesus' name,
according to your will, you are going to grant. Glory
Yes.
Yes. As we come to open this prayer and to pray one
for another. Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Glory be to God. Your word said we know we have passed from death to life because we love
the brethren. Yes.
Hallelujah. So we thank you because life is abiding in us today. Glory
yes.
be to God. Hallelujah.
Yes.
As we praise you, glory be to Jesus.
Yes.
This morning, glory be to God, we bring our government before thee.
Our government,
you said in
yes.
your word that first we must pray for kings, glory be to God.
Yes.
That we might be able to live a peaceable life in the earth.
Yes.
So we bring our government
yes.
before you. Lord, it has been everything else but peace.
Yes.
But we as the saints of God have abide in your peace.
Yes.
So we pray that you will move, glory be to God.
Move by your spirit, God.
We pray that glory be to God, hallelujah, intervene. Your word said you have given the earth to the children of men.
Yes,
yes. And because you have given us the earth and you have given us the government of the earth, we now lay that government back on your shoulders.
Yes, yes,
God.
Yes.
We're asking that you will intervene, that you will take over. Glory be to God. Lord, you have a way of moving.
Yes.
Glory be to God.
Yes.
That glory to Kashari Bayasaba. Hallelujah. And we thank you because the way of the Lord is right.
Yes.
And it rejoices the heart.
Yes.
We are moving our government another time. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. The secret petitions that we have brought before thee, glory be to God, because of the devastations that's in the earth, we pray that you will answer our prayer in the name of Jesus as you move. Glory be to God. Hallelujah.
Yes.
We thank you for peace in the nation. We pray that the land will be healed.
Healed.
You said in your word that if we would pray
yes.
and humble ourselves,
yes, you will heal the lands.
Glory
yes,
be to God.
Yes.
Lord, we have been praying. Glory be to
yes.
God. Hallelujah. And sometimes we have humbled ourselves, but then we refuse to turn.
Yes.
You said if we humble ourselves and make a turn,
yes.
glory be to God. Hallelujah.
We're going to hear from heaven.
We will hear from heaven.
Glory.
And you will heal our lands.
Yes.
Our lands need to be healed in the name of Jesus.
Glory.
Glory be to God. The land need to be healed. Glory be to God. We pray that you will raise up intercessors. Lord, the church is a sleeping giant. We pray that you will tap them on their shoulder. Call them, glory be to God, in whispers of love.
Oh, God.
Pick them up, glory be to God. Hallelujah.
Oh, shout out, Bambi.
Whatever it would take to get their attention.
Yes.
Glory be to God. Move on them and wake them up that they might intercede.
Yes.
That our voices might go up, glory be to God, towards heaven. And
yes.
interceding, glory be to God, that our land might be healed.
Yes.
Glory be to God, so Lord, heal our lands.
Uh-huh.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes,
God,
here.
Hear and answer prayer.
Oh, God.
None beside you.
None but thee.
Everlasting Father. Yes.
Prince of Peace.
Thank you.
Thank you,
Lord.
We thank you for your magnificence in the earth.
Oh, yes.
In the earth another time.
In the name
God,
of Jesus.
Spirit move on the waters.
Yes.
Yes. In the name of Jesus.
Glory.
So we give your name the praise. We pray for those that are going into the workforce this morning. Glory
yes,
be to
yeah,
God. Hallelujah.
Yeah, yes.
We thank you. We pray, glory be to God, that you will move on their lives, that and they eat and they're working, they're sleeping and they're drinking. Glory be to God. And whatever they do, that they will manifest. Glory be to God, the love of Jesus Christ, that they will manifest God in their life, their everyday life, their everyday walking, their everyday talking. Glory be to God. So we bless your wonderful name.
Yes.
By your spirit. Strengthen your people. Let the word of God come. Glory be to God like water.
Yes, yes, yes. Yes.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
Soaking the earth another time in the name of Jesus. Let the word of God, glory be to God, soak our hearts. Break up the fiber wrong in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
And every petitioner and everyone, glory be to God, hallelujah, that have requested prayer.
Yes.
We thank you because you are the answer. Glory be to God, hallelujah.
Yes.
You are the answer to all prayer.
Yes.
You said that whatever we ask,
ask the Father in Jesus' name.
To your will, you're going to do it. So do it in the name of Jesus. We pray, glory be to God, for the family of this young pastor.
Yes.
Lord, I know this man personally.
Yes.
And he was cut off. Glory be to God, hallelujah, in you. Glory be to God, hallelujah.
Yes.
But we pray that you will move by your spirit. We pray that you will wake your people up. Teach them how to pray. Teach them how to seek thee. Teach them how to stay, glory be to God, behind the hedge of protection.
Yes.
Teach them how to walk with thee. That
yes.
The devil will not cut us off in our prime.
Yes.
Cut us off for our time.
Yes,
glory
yes,
be to God,
yes.
Hallelujah. So we pray the wonderful name and we worship and adore you. We magnify and lift you up this morning. Glory be to God. We pray that you will strengthen his family.
Yes.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Let them see that this is not the hand of God, but this is the work of the enemy.
Yes.
Because the devil come to
steal.
He stole him in his youth.
Yes.
He come to steal and to destroy. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. And because we are not conscious of the thief, we let the thief come in and take from us.
Yes.
The thief come in and take our family because we don't know how to go out against the thief, how to work against the thief. But God give this your people a spirit of understanding.
Yes.
Not only wisdom, but understanding that they might understand thee. Glory be to God. And understanding thee, they'll be able to stand against the thief in the name of Jesus. And
yes.
So God move in your spirit.
Yes.
We pray that you will bless our apostle.
Yes.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah.
Yes.
As you touch him, as the spirit of prayer rests upon him.
Yes.
As the spirit of teaching rests upon him. We pray, glory be to God, that the blessedness of God, glory be to God, will be upon him. We pray for pastors in the name of Jesus. Lord, these people, glory be to God, are doing your work.
Yes.
Glory be to God, they're persecuted in the earth.
Yes.
People come out against but we bind the forces of darkness
in the name of Jesus.
Glory be to God, stop the plans of the enemy. Lord, you have called them to lead your people.
Yes.
Glory be to God, hallelujah, the path for your people to walk.
Yes.
Glory be to God that they will rise up under the anointing
and
do what you have called them to do.
Yes.
Even as they constantly humble themselves in your presence.
Yes.
Strengthen
them.
Job in the vineyard, because you have sent us forth in the vineyard, and you said in your book to give us what is right.
Yes.
As we wait for what is right.
Yes.
We pray that you will strengthen us, strengthen our hands to do the work, strengthen our minds to serve thee. Glory
yes.
be to God, hallelujah.
Yes.
Glory be to God, hallelujah. Give us a strength, glory be to God, that can only come from your spirit in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Let it, glory be to God, be neutral. Glory be to God, hallelujah, as we stretch forth our hands to thee, stretch forth your hands to us. Glory be to God that we would be in relationship. Glory be to God, hallelujah, that we would be relationship with thee. And we thank and praise and glorify your name and lift up your name and magnify your name because of who you are, because of your wonderful, yes, glory be to God, mercies, because of your great compassion, glory be to God, hallelujah. So as we bless your name, as we lift, yes, up your name, yes, as we magnify, yes, your name, we receive the blessedness of God this morning in the name of Jesus. And we thank you for doing all that we have asked in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Yes.
We bless you. Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
We thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Well, we thank you, Pastor Hinds, for praying for us this morning. And we thank God for all those who have been saying amen to the prayer. I know some of the phones are mute, but we give God the praise and the glory for answering that prayer and on our behalf this morning in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. You know, when Pastor Hinds was praying, we have to come out against the plans of the enemy, because he just told one of the giants out of the mist, one of the great soldiers out of the mist. You know what Ephesians chapter 5 and verse number 8 said? We were once in darkness, but now you are in the light of the Lord. Walk as children of the light. Because we are walking as children of the light, we know that whatever Satan has been planning and whatever he planned against us, every destructive weapon, and this is what this prayer is all about, because we don't want the devil to come in and keep stealing from us, and we let him go by and say, and many people preaching, then they talk about the Lord take this and the Lord do this, and many things that we call the Lord is not the Lord. Amen. And many things that we call the devil is not the devil. I let you know that last week as we begin to bring the word of the Lord. So Ephesians 5 and 8 said, for you were once in darkness. Amen. You were once in darkness. We didn't have the revelation like we have now. Praise God. We didn't have the knowledge like we have now. But now, amen. But now he said, we are children. We are to walk in, as children of the light. And Colossians 1 and 10 said that ye might walk worthy of the Lord, pleasing him. Amen. Being fruitful in every good work and increasing in the knowledge of God. Let me say that again, that you walk worthy. That's what Colossians 1 and 10 said, that you walk worthy of the Lord, pleasing him, and being fruitful in every good work, increasing in the knowledge of God. Praise the Lord. Sister Marcia from Trinidad, thank you for joining with us. Pastor Diane Greenwich, God bless you. Thank you for joining with us this morning in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Oh, bless the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We pray you would continue to share this link with your friends and loved one on Facebook, wherever you are. God bless you. Share this link with your friends. And then when we go off the air or while we're on the air, you can still get us on YouTube after we go off. Amen. And share that line. Go to International Prayer Conference and then you'll find us there. And share that link with your friends and loved one. Amen. So that this prayer can go around the world for the glory of God. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We love you all, and we really do appreciate what God is doing through this prayer conference. Many are being delivered. Many are being saved. Amen. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. This morning, we want to pray for a young man that drove us around in Ghana. He was like an armor bearer to me for many years, and to Bishop Nelson. He was a chauffeur for many, many years. Amen. His wife had just passed away, and she's 49 years old. She just went home. Raphael's wife, honey, you remember Raphael? Amen. His wife had just passed away. Amen. And we need to pray for him also in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We pray for that family. Amen. They were doing great and mighty things. And the devil also afflicted her with cancer. And when she found out that she didn't stay very long, amen, but she had passed on. And so we want to pray for her and for that family also. People are calling us everywhere for prayer, amen, and reminded us that this prayer is getting through somewhere. Remember that we are on YouTube. Get there and get on International Prayer Conference. Thank you, Evangelist, for reminding us. Amen. And get to International Prayer Conference and share that also. That's where people are going and they're enjoying this. Amen. Every day we're getting not only on text, amen, but on email and reminding us that this prayer is going places in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We're extending it around the world and across the ear in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Bless him. Is Elder Boston on the line? Praise the Lord. Amen. I didn't hear him this morning. God bless you. God, thank you for joining with us this morning. I want you to pray for the ministers, and Pastor Hinds, pray for us. I want you to pray for her this morning, and also pray for a minister who is in Ghana, West Africa. He was like our adjutant who drove us around. His wife had just passed. I want you to pray for them also this morning in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Can you do that for us this morning in Jesus' name?
Yes, yes, sir. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you for your goodness and for your mercy. We thank you, O Father, for truly this is the day that you have made.
Yes.
And we shall be glad and rejoice in it. Father, we just want to bless you, Lord, this morning.
Yes.
We want to Shabbat you, God. We want to glorify you, God.
Yes.
Because you are wonderful. You are marvelous in all
yes.
that I do.
Yes.
Father, we just want to give you the morning glory from the fruit of our lips.
Yes.
You are wonderful. You are
yes.
kind.
Yes.
You are generous, God. You are long-suffering with us, God. We
yes.
thank you, O Father, for your word and your wisdom. We thank you, Lord, for your concepts and your precepts and your principles, God.
Yes.
That you have mandated us, O God, down through the years. Now, Father, we ask you to bless this woman of God. Continue, Lord, to undergird her. Continue, Lord, to saturate your presence once again upon her life.
Yes.
God, in the name of Jesus. God.
Yes.
Now, Father, as she pour herself out, God, we
yes.
ask you, Lord, to replenish her, God.
Yes.
Every area of her life, God. Oh, God, keep her covered under your blood.
Yes.
Hide her behind the cross. Renew her strength in the name of Jesus, God. Father, if there's anything that is lacking upon her life, God, we ask you, Lord, to super supplenish it, God, according to perspective and according to thy will, God. Oh, God, bless her hands, God.
Yes,
bless her feet, God. Bless her mouth, her mind, God, in the totality of her being.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus. God.
Yes.
Our God, we are also touching and agreeing for the gentlemen who are just transitioned, God, for your word to declare, God, those who are absent in body, God, who are present in the Lord.
Yes.
So we celebrate you, Father.
Yeah.
We celebrate you, God, for this man of God. We thank you, Lord, for the legacy that he has left undone upon the earth, God. Our God, continue, Lord, to bless his family, God.
Yeah, yeah.
Continue, Lord, to undergird them, God, in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
God. Oh, God, stretch forth your hand, God, of your loving kindness, God.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus, God. Our God, undergird them, God. Give them peace within their minds and their
yes.
spirit. In the name of Jesus. God.
Yes.
Ah, God, we glorify you, God. We magnify thy name.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus, God. Oh, yeah. God, there is nothing that is taken by surprise.
Yes.
You, God. But everything is ordered by the divine will.
Yes.
The perfect will of God. So we celebrate you, Father.
Yes. Yes.
In the name of Jesus, God.
Yes.
Ah, God, bless our leaders in a special way, God. Keep them undergirded with your word and with your kindness. God.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
God, move by thy spirit. Move
Rabbi,
by thy
yes.
word, God. Move by your compassion, God, because it faileth not. In the name of Jesus, God. Now, Father, as we end this prayer, but never from your presence, nor from your sight. Yes, these blessings are put into the word of God. In the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Thank you. Thank you, Elder Boston. And we believe God for his word. Amen. Amen. We, as we said before, that the devil comes to steal, to kill. Thank you, Maureen Small. Thank you for joining with us. I think this is from Pennsylvania. God bless you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And we want to praise God because His light has come to us. We are able to receive the knowledge of Jesus Christ. Amen. Sometimes the devil comes to rob us. He comes to steal. He come to kill. He come to destroy. But we have overcoming powers today in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's why we come out this morning to declare that we have victory in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Again, this morning, we want to look at the word of the Lord. Amen. We have not finished with what we began on Wednesday. Praise God. And we want to continue on this same trend. We reminded you of the connection we have with God. Amen. And that connection that we have with Him brings us into a place that we can truly say that we have an encounter with God. And that's what each individual need to have in the presence of God. And that's not just to come to sing, to join the crowd. Amen. That's what most people does, is they just join the crowd and do what the crowd do. But we want to be a little different. We don't just want to be a part of the crowd. We want to have an encounter with God. When Moses, and I told you, let's go to the scripture in Exodus chapter 3, amen, verses 2 to 8, amen, Exodus chapter 3, verses 2 to 8, if Evangelist Holly's on the line, she's going to be our reader this morning, amen, and I don't know if Sister Camille is on the line this morning. If Camille is on the line, she is going to read also from Joshua chapter 3, verses 13 to 15. So Evangelist Holly, you're going to read for us from Exodus chapter 3, verses 2 to 8, and that's from the King James Version. And then we're going to have Camille read from Joshua chapter 5, verses 13 to 15. God bless you all as you would read the scripture in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise the Lord. Reading from Exodus chapter 3, verses 2 to 8 from the King James Version. And the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a flame of fire out of the midst of a bush. And he looked, and behold, the bush burned with fire, and the bush was not consumed. And Moses said, I will now turn aside and see this great sight, why the bush is not burnt.
Yes.
And when the Lord saw that he turned aside to see, God called unto him out of the midst of the bush, and said, Moses, Moses. And he said, Here am I. And he said, Draw not nigh hither. Put off thy shoes from off thy feet, for the place whereon thou standest is holy ground. Moreover, he said, I am the God of thy father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. And Moses hid his face, for he was afraid to look upon God. And the Lord said, I have surely seen the affliction of my people which are in Egypt, and have heard their cry by reason of their taskmasters, for I know their sorrow. And I am come down to deliver them out of the hand of the Egyptians, and to bring them up out of that land into a good land and a large, unto a land flowing with milk and honey, unto the place of the Canaanites and the Hittites and the Amorites and the Perizzites and the Hivites and the Jebusites.
Amen. Joshua chapter 5, verses 13 to 15. Sister Camille? Is she there? Amen.
Read Sister
Hull if you have it.
Joshua chapter 5, verses 13 to 15. Yes. And it reads, And it came to pass, when Joshua was by Jericho, that he lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, there stood a man over against him with his sword drawn in his hand. And Joshua went unto him and said unto him, Art thou for us, or for our adversary? And he said, Nay, but as captain of the host of the Lord am I now come. And Joshua fell on his face to the earth, and did worship, and said unto him, What saith my Lord unto his servant?
Verse 15.
And the captain of the Lord's host said unto Joshua, Loose thy shoe from off thy foot, for the place whereon thou standest is holy. And Joshua did so.
The command of the Lord is wonderful. But it is wonderful when we have an encounter with Him. The encounter with God, and for those who have never had an encounter with God, each one of us have a different experience as we connect with Him. Each one of us. Moses' encounter was similar to Joshua, but they all understand that when God arrives on the scene, there is for a special purpose. And sometimes God must do something to capture our attention. Yes, He does something, as I said on Wednesday. God must always do something to capture our attention. Sometimes we are so busy doing our own thing that we forget that the Bible said, in all thy ways we ought to acknowledge the Lord, and He will direct our path. And so sometimes we are so busy taken up with so much things that we missed out the encounter we should have with God. Moses was Moses was always a busy man. And Moses was what I call a hands-on man. He liked to touch everything. In fact, if you would read the scripture, his father-in-law tell him he couldn't do everything himself. Not he would have killed himself, but he had to appoint 70 elders to help him to carry on. Each one of us must know who is our help. Moses at this time had saw, as I told you, he saw many bush that was burning before, but this one that he saw was different, because this bush was burning but not consumed. It was not consumed. That captured the attention of Moses. His attention was drawn by this. He said, how come I saw other bush burning and it was burnt up, but this one is burning, but the bush remained green? So he said, I'll turn aside to see. The problem with most of us, we don't take time off to turn aside to see what is going on around us. Amen. We let things just go past. But Moses said, I'll now turn aside to see this great sight. And as he turned aside to draw close to recognize what, or to see what is going on and to recognize what is going on, the Lord spoke to him. Amen. The Lord spoke to him out of the burning bush. Amen. God called him. The first thing he does, he called him out of the mist. Notice the word said, and God called him out of the mist of the mist of the bush. Sometimes when the more trouble you see, you think that that trouble is to drive you away from God. But that trouble that he was seeing, that thing that he was seeing, that bush that was burning, the Bible said that was a call of God. Amen. God called him out of the midst of the burning bush. Oh, glory to God. And when God called you, there's a reason for the call. Amen. Why he was calling him, this is not for leadership only, but this is for deliverance. Sometimes he calls us for leadership and then he's calling us for deliverance. This was to remind Moses and the children of Israel that at this time, I'm not only going to lead them, but I'm going to deliver you. I'm going to deliver you out of the hands of the enemy. So he said, for me to deliver you, you got to know who I am. Amen. Draw nigh unto me. Take your shoes off your feet. Now, moreover, he said, I am the God of your father. I am the God of Abraham. I am the God of Isaac. I am the God of Jacob. Amen. And when Moses heard that, the Bible said he hid his face. He hid his face. Amen. We're not feisty when we come to God. We're not feisty. We have to learn how to, when God is speaking to us, how we ought to worship him. how we ought to throw ourselves at his feet and worship him. In fact, the Bible said that God is the Spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in spirit and in truth. The Bible said that Moses was afraid. Why was Moses afraid? Because if you would read the Old Testament, no one have ever seen God and live. Amen. And so he's throwing himself at the feet of God. And God said, this is not the time for death. This is the time for you to live. Amen. And I want the whole, not only for you to live, but I want the entire Israel to live also. He said, I have seen the affliction. Glory to God. Somebody on this prayer line this morning ought to know that God has seen the affliction to which you have passed. Amen. And God is not ignoring the affliction that has afflicted you. Glory to God. And what the devil has been trying to do to you. Amen. He's trying to burn things around you so that you might run away from it. But the God of heaven can speak out of a mist of a burning bush. And the Bible said, he said, I have seen the affliction, what the Egyptians has done. Why might God create fire so that he can talk about what the affliction that the children of Israel was going through. And he said, I'm come down to deliver them. I'm delivering them out of the hard taskmaster. I'm coming down to deliver them out of the land of Egypt and bring them into a good land. Praise God. I'm bringing them into a good land. God wants to bring you to a good place. There is a place in God that only God can take you there. The Hittites, the Perizzites, and all these other sites that were there, they were occupying the land. They were occupying the land. The Bible said it was a large land. Amen. It was the place of the Canaanites, the Hittites, the Amorites, and the Perizzites, the Hittites, and the Jebusites. All of them occupied the land, and there were oppositions to God. And if you look at them from the outward view, viewing them, you will be scared and afraid. But when God gives a word, when God gives a word that they cannot stand before you, amen. Why? They were standing in a large land, amen. And they were occupying the land that was flowing with milk and honey. Glory to God. Amen. And he said, this is the land of the Canaanites. But God said, I'm going to reverse some stuff and I'm going to give it to you. Amen. All because Moses recognized the voice of God speaking to him out of the midst of the burning bush. Can I say this to you this morning? Have you recognized it is God and not the devil? Amen. Because it was burning, you're rebuking stuff, you're casting out demons and all kind of stuff. But I come to let you know, it's the voice of God this morning. Same way after the death of Moses. After the death of Moses, Moses has gone to be with the Lord. And in chapter 5 of the book of Joshua, amen, the Bible said that here comes Joshua. Amen. And I was preaching a few Sundays ago, and I told him that the first stop that he met was he came to a place called Gilgad. Amen. And Gilgad was a place that of sanctification. That's the place that they cut off their foreskin and they roll it away because many of the children that was in going to the promised land was not circumcised. Amen. Because their father and their grandfather and their grandmother and great grandmother died because of unbelief. But now God have reiterate his word and given them the commandment again that they're going to this land that is flowing with milk and honey. Amen. They have not got there under Moses, praise God, but they must get there under Joshua. Joshua leadership is a little bit different. So the Bible said, and it came to pass that when Joshua was by Jericho, thank God that they leave the wilderness, they come through the Red Sea. Praise God. God divided the Red Sea. They came over the Red Sea. They are on the other side now. But now they come to another obstacle in life. Just because you came through some stuff, amen, that does not mean that all the obstacles in your life are over. Amen. some people think that they have made it because they encounter some stuff and they said, my night is fat, the night is over. But every now and then we come up against another obstacle before us. He is now by Jericho. Joshua was by Jericho. You know, the Jericho walls are tall and it's big. It is the enemy is on top of the wall. The enemy is beyond the wall. Amen. And they're trying to prevent you from getting to your prophetic destiny. There are many things in your life that look big and tall, but I come to prophesy to you this morning in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ that as long as you get to Jericho, God is going to give you the equipment how to surpass and how to overcome the situations in your life. So before when he got there, the Bible said that when he got by Jericho, here comes it now, this fighter, this warrior, Joshua, the Bible said he looked up and saw a man with the sword drawn in his hands. Amen. And then the Bible said, the Bible said about Moses that Moses turned aside to see the great sight. But the Bible said, and Joshua went unto him. Glory to God. Joshua went unto him and said, art thou for us? Joshua recognized that the only person that he should be leading the army was himself, but he recognized that somebody was standing, and he thought that the person that was standing against him was the enemy. It is not the enemy. It is God taking up his new position, not only to be fighting for you, but to lead you. Glory to God. I want to let you know that God wants to lead you this morning, and God wants to take you to this place that he wants you. And he asked the Lord the question. He said unto him, art thou for us or for our adversary? Are you for us? If you are for us, you join us over here. Glory to God. Amen. And if you are for our adversaries, start killing them out right away. And the Lord said, nay, but I'm sent as the captain of the host of the Lord, and I'm now come. And then the Bible said, just like Moses did, that Joshua fell on his face. He fell on his face and worshiped. He did worship, give obedience to God. He worshiped. Yeah, amen. He worshiped the Lord. I want to let us know we are in a position right now to worship God. I know there's a lot of us who like to praise God, but the worship with God is an intimate relationship. When we're going to tell God who he is, you are our Jehovah Jireh. You are Jehovah. Call him. Amen. He's the darling of your soul. He is a rock. He is a friend. Amen. And you begin to worship him. Amen. Amen. And love him up this morning because he has showed up on your behalf this morning. You know, sometimes God shows up for us and we don't even remember to give him thanks. Amen. But the Bible said that he showed up and he did worship. Amen. And then he asked the Lord, before he asked the Lord anything, the first thing he did was to worship. We come, before we worship, the first thing we do is to ask him for things, not Joshua. Before he ask God even for the direction or what the Lord would say to him, the Bible said that Joshua did worship him. And then he asked him, what did the Lord say unto his servant? And the captain of the Lord's host said unto Joshua, loose your shoes. I know you're worshiping. Amen. Amen. I want you to take your shoes off. I want you to understand that you're worshiping, but there's still some old stuff that you have on you. You've got to take it off and get rid of the old mentality. Get rid of the old stuff. Amen. You've been running too long. I don't want you to run no longer. You are right. You're at the right place at the right time. This is the place I can have an encounter with you, and you can have an encounter with me, and you're having it right now. And you can't keep in the same posture with your shoes on. Take your shoes off. Glory to God. Amen. Loose your shoes off of thy feet, for the place where thou standest is holy. When God consecrate a place, glory to God, and when God call it, called out to you and say it is holy, it is just holy. This place is dedicated to God. It is dedicated for service. And what God requires from you is service. God's service. Amen. And what is God's service? What is God requiring from you in his service? That we should worship him in spirit and in truth. Amen. And I'm glad because the Bible said, and Joshua without any hesitation, glory to God, without inquiring, he could have acted like some of us Americans, you know. Lord, why do you want me to take off my shoes? If I take off my shoes, it's embarrassing to take off my shoes. No, amen. If God said, take them off, loose thy shoes from off your foot. Take it off. If God said, take it off, and there's some things that God is asking you to take off, amen. But you think that I can't do without it, amen. But the Lord said to him, get the shoes off your feet right now, for the place where thou standest is holy. And then the Bible said, and Joshua did so. Let me ask the people on this prayer line, have you did so what God required of you to do? Amen. Have you taken off your shoes? Have you loved one another? Are you walking in love? Do you love the Lord with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your spirit? And Joshua did so. Moses and Joshua both had an experience of a holy ground encounter with God. They had a holy ground encounter with God. And let me say this morning to the saints of God, you also can have this holy encounter with God. Amen. Amen. One regards to Israel, and one, the first encounter with God, getting them out of Egypt. That was Moses to get them out of Egypt. Amen. And the second encounter is to get them now into Canaan. Amen. One is to get them out of Egypt, and the next one is to get them into Canaan. Praise God. Every encounter is different. One is to bring you out, and one is to take you in. And some people are just satisfied with the encounter to get them out. Amen. And once they get out, they feel that they're all right. But I'm grateful this morning for the encounter, glory to God, that is going to get you into Canaan. Glory to God. Glory to God. Amen. These two encounters with God happened because God brought them to a place that he can sanctify the place, and they had this encounter. Glory to God. I want to say this to somebody this morning, amen. This encounter with him is, you must know when it is an encounter for what? Whether it's to bring you out or whether it's going to take you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And God must lead you into both encounter. You must allow him. What this encounter with him, he is going to give you direction, whether he is going to pull you out or whether he is pulling you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Glory to God. And Joshua chapter 6 and verse number 2, because he was taking them in now, he's taking them out. Joshua chapter 6 and verse number 2, amen, it said, and the Lord said unto Joshua, see, I have given into thy hands Jericho. Amen. He don't have it yet, but the Lord said he have not, because the giants and the walls were still thick. But the Lord said, see, glory to God. You got to be able to see, glory to God. See, oh God, help me this morning. Amen. You got to see what you're going to get before you get it. And God said, see that you have it. See that you have it. Your eyes must be able to see that you have it. Oh, and some people say, I got to hold it first to tell somebody I have it. No, in the eyes of God, God said you have it long before you get into it. Because I'm leading you. I'm leading you into your promise. Glory to God. See, I've given you into thy hands Jericho, and the kings thereof, and the mighty men of valor. That is Joshua chapter 6 and verse number 2. God said, I've given you both the association. God said, the first, if you can see what I did first, I have divided the water that you came over. Glory to God. And this wall is not too thick that I can't give you, I can't allow you to go. God said, I'm with you. Amen. The Red Sea was divided. Amen. Jordan was divided. Amen. And now he comes to the place where he having to take over what God has promised to them. The experience with God, the experience that they have to show them that God is with them, is when they have the encounter with God on the holy ground. Glory to God. Every bias must be broken. Glory to God. Let me say this morning. Every barrier in your life must be broken as long as you have this encounter with God. God bless you. We're going to hear from Pastor Hinds, and then I'm going to come back and pray with you in Jesus' name.
Amen. I'm just going to do this quickly because I want you to pray with the people. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. But you know, Bishop, you said something that both of these men had a experience with God. Both was told by God to take off their shoes. And
yes.
Both of them were obedient. What they did, they gave way to the higher power. Now,
yes.
Moses knew there was leadership in him.
Yes.
And when God spoke, Moses changed his direction.
Yes.
Joshua now carried a sword. I like Joshua. Joshua was a militant leader.
Yes.
And when Joshua saw how the people disrespected Moses.
Yes.
And how the people, and some of the things that the people do, the people were crazy.
Yes.
If Moses said stand, the people wanted to sit.
Yes.
If Moses gave a command, whatever Moses did, the people wanted to do the opposite. But Joshua was a man with a sword. Joshua was a man with a sword. And the thing is about Joshua, when Joshua saw an angel with a sword, Joshua knew that he was a man with a sword.
Yes.
And when he saw the angel with a sword, he wanted to know, hey, are you for us or are you against us? But I like the answer that the angel gave.
Yes.
I didn't come to take sides. The angel said, I didn't come to take sides. I come to represent God.
Yes, yes, yes.
In other words, what he was saying, Joshua, I am not saying when you make it about you, you will always be offended.
Yes.
Humility. Pastors, humility. Look for the saint that is humble. The saint that is humble, and when you speak, will back off. That is the saint that will help you in the ministry. Humility is the greatest thing. And sometimes the help that God gives you, you don't want. Because that person is not clicky-clicky.
Yes.
That person is not lovey-dovey. But that person is the one that will accomplish the task.
Yes.
That person is the one that will accomplish the task. And the angel said, you see, you cannot make it about you. Ministry is not about you.
Yes.
Ministry is about God. It is about what God wants.
Yes.
Glory be to God. And Joshua gave way to the higher one.
Yes.
The Bible said that he told you, take off your shoes.
Yes.
Put away self. Put away self. You can't walk in these shoes. I'm calling you to a higher calling. Take them off.
Yes.
Take them off.
Yes.
You know, put away your ways. Change your ways. And Joshua fell on his face. I love Joshua. A man with a sword that could humble himself is a powerful man.
Yes.
The sword is the word of God. A man that carries the word of God. You know God called you. You know you are anointed. And you can humble yourself. You are a powerful man.
Yes.
And he worshiped. I'm going to say this quickly about worship. I have been praising God for years, and so many things was never accomplished in my life. And I couldn't understand why I jumped the highest, screamed the loudest, and nothing happened. But then I came to the place to worship. And when I worship him, things begin to happen in a miraculous way. Joshua fell on his face. He fell on his face, and he worshiped, and he worshiped. The question here, I got to do this quickly. The question here that Joshua asked that tells me this is a powerful man. And Joshua fell on his face and worshiped and said unto him, what said my Lord to his servant? Joshua was teachable.
Yes.
No wonder he was Moses' minister. You know, we had our bishop that has passed and gone to be with the Lord. We were in wonderful district 3. He unreachable. If you're not faithful, God cannot use you. And if you're always gone on Sunday morning, God cannot use you. And if you're not humble enough to be taught, God cannot use you. Faithful, available, and teachable. So what you have to do is, when God speaks, humble yourself. Amen.
God bless you, Pastor Hinds. We just have a few minutes, so I'm going to start praying right now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Father, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we thank you because you are putting a halt on every demonic movement right now and all of the satanic activities, hallelujah, that is trying to surround God's people to prevent them from getting into their promise. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we rip down the walls of Jericho because you have given us the land to occupy, the land that is flowing with milk and honey. Every uncertainty that has come to cause us to go in the spirit of the Torah and to rest upon us to turn us around, by the power and the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we come against you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Put a halt to all of his movements now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I ask you, Jesus, that thou will contend with those who try to contend with God's people. Fight against those who try to fight against God's people. Be our shield and be our buckler. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, let terror strike the hearts of the enemy in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and cause their hearts to fail within them now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. This Friday, this victorious Friday, we pray that the saints of God will be victorious in every area, financially, spiritually, emotionally, and otherwise. Open the two-leaf gates for the people of God. Lead them into the room of worship and give them an encounter with you like they have never seen before, so that they can say the Lord of hosts is with us and the God of Jacob is our refuge. Now bless us one by one. Lord, this prayer line is coming to an end this morning, but we are not going to stop because we finished praying in this session. But let your people have the spirit of prayer resting upon them and the spirit of worship, that they will throw themselves constantly at your feet and that you might speak out of heaven and speak to them in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We thank you, Lord, for answering our prayer in Jesus' name. Somebody ought to give him a praise right there in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord, have your way, have your way. Hallelujah. Koshere barusa bahata. Hando uruba kashanda. Yasamba hute yapko kore bianda. Have your way now. Hallelujah. And we bless your name and we worship you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. God barusa bakanda. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. Thank you for joining with us this morning. And we thank you for the presence of the Lord that we enjoyed this morning. We're going to leave you, but we're going to give God the hallelujah and give him the highest praise in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you his peace, both now and forevermore. And let the peace of God that passeth all understanding keep your heart and mind stayed upon you. I greet you the way that the Apostle Paul teaches us how to greet both the Jews and the Gentiles. Amen. Grace and peace be multiplied to you from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. Have a great day in the name of the Lord. Bye-bye in Jesus' name.
Amen. God bless you all. May the peace of God rest upon you all.
Amen. Thank you. Thank you.